Hello, everybody.
Hey, everybody.
It's Karen and Erica today.
It's our 100th episode.
And we are so excited to share this with you. In fact, we've written a song just for you. Here we go. I started a podcast. Had some stories to tell. All of you knew this. Because you're here right now. I'm in disbelief. Because you're all still here. So this song is for you. I'm grateful as hell. I want to thank you for listening to this show, my friends. Thank you for letting me invade your ears again. Doctors can be monsters. Nurses scary too. Keep your eyes wide open. They're coming after you. Erica driving to the ER in 6 seconds flat. Yelling through the doorway. Karen, where you at?
Over here.
I want to thank you for listening to this show, my friends. Thank you for letting me invade your ears again.
And again.
And one more time. Let's go.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody, for listening to that.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Are you ready for what's coming up?
I don't think you are.
Well, I thought that was pretty good.
I think that's our best song yet.
And it was from the heart because we do want to thank you.
Everything.
Can't believe that. I mean, I'm gonna sound like one of those. It all started in a little room with a little microphone and just a I almost called her Racy. Hi, Racy.
Racy.
Crazy.
Sorry about that.
That's okay. No, she can be part of the show because we're going to include a lot of things in this show. But honestly, I can't believe that I've hit the 100th episode.
I can't believe it.
There's been so many ups and downs. Like, there's been times where
she was dreaming of finding me, and then she found me. That's what it was. It was like it took her, 75 episodes to find me?
It did, actually. So and I'm, then, yeah. You know, the rest is history.
Clearly, by listening to the songs, you know that it's history. Because it's going down in history, and
you know what I'm closing. You know what we're closing in on?
What?
The 1 million mark of downloads.
That's insane.
I know.
Like insane.
I can't believe it.
I think we're gonna have to write a song for it.
It's gonna have to be. It's a million because we won't be able to say it. It's a million downloads now.
We'll do it to a different tune.
No, of course we will.
Like "Oops, I Did It Again" by Britney Spears.
Yeah. Oops, I got a million.
Downloads.
It makes me so happy right down in my toes.
See, she's already started writing.
That's already started. So today's show is going to be, I'm hoping that it's going to be a ton of fun. What I did was I spent almost 11 hours yesterday just going through every single episode Erica and I have done together.
Now she's over exaggerating because she told me 10 and a half. So,
okay, so
I mean,
10 and a half
let's
hours.
Not get crazy.
But I have to say... that honestly it was some of the best 10 hours of my life.
She sent me a few clips over text and I honestly just about died. I
gave myself a laughing migraine. Like honestly the time just flew. I started it and then I look up and I'm like, what
are we gonna wait a bit before we play some of these? Or
I think we're gonna break it up. We're gonna bits and pieces. I asked a bunch of people, or I didn't ask a bunch, I asked everybody on the Facebook group to send in some kind of question, comment, whatever about the podcast. And I also asked whoever would, send in a voice message. So we got a couple, and awesome. We're going to pick their names out of a hat. And
okay.
One of them will win a stat mask.
And I just got to tell you, I got one of these masks, and it is the greatest fucking thing you've ever seen in your life. So,
and we'll custom make it for you. It can say whatever you want on it.
So mine says, Karen for my birthday, got Karen and Mary got me these really fucking cool gifts. I'm just going to talk about them for a sec.
Okay.
So she got me this. Okay. You know, it's a mask, and it says, I speak moistly. Amazing. Then she got me this book, and it's called How to Swear, an illustrated guide. So it teaches you how to politely swear, nouns, verbs, you know, these fun things.
Grammatically correct.
Very grammatically correct. Yeah. And then, you ready? The piece de resistance. You know, like a prayer candle, and it's got like Mary or Jesus on it. It's this one is a prayer candle, but it is Betty White. So I'm going to take a picture of the thing she got me and post it on the Facebook page.
I think it's funny that Kyle said, does it smell like Betty White?
And it does smell like Betty White.
Does it smell like flowers and happiness?
It does, actually. Yeah.
That's it. As long as it doesn't smell like Gwyneth Paltrow's vagina, then...
Like a can of tuna? Like a can of tuna with a candle in it.
Ugh. Oh, you know what? That is a good segue.
I think it's a great segue. I think you should play it there, Karen.
Well, Erica and I gross each other out.
Yes.
A lot. And it's not necessarily a bad thing. We just do. So going through the clips, I noticed that there's a lot of gag sounds throughout it, and genuine gag sounds.
Yes.
So I'm going to play for you right now the clip of a bunch of our gag sounds. Enjoy.
It made me almost want to puke. Smell
of chokes. What is...
What?
Oh, God.
I don't even know how... Like, this is what Karen did yesterday. All day.
I took everything out that I thought was awesome, and I could have... Honestly, we can do a part two of this. Maybe
I think we should.
At the 125th episode, maybe we can do this again. But honestly, I got so much like enjoyment out of this. I think more than just you and I will like this.
I absolutely agree. And I think for the next one, we should try and figure out how many times you and I together collectively say like.
Oh, I know. It's terrible.
I'm always like.
Whatever. It's how we talk.
It is how we talk.
You're toki.
Yeah.
Oh, well, speaking of that, there are times when I have difficulty saying things.
Yes.
And... You do it every once in a while.
I do.
Or you try to find a nice way of correcting me.
Yes.
So how about we play that clip right now?
I think this is going to be great. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
Butterfly effect.
Butterfly effect.
I can't talk ever.
It's okay. I think it's funny and I'm kind of enjoying it.
Vagina. Centrifugal.
Centrifugal force.
Centrifugal.
Centrifugal.
I have a vaginal. Southwest.
Southwest.
In Southwest China.
Burrowers. There you go. That's just a few.
We don't know how to speak.
The one that's the shortest one, it goes, vagina.
Vagina.
You can barely hear it. Then it says, my vaginal or something like that.
My vaginal.
I have a vaginal.
Oh my God, Karen.
You think my own parts that I would.
No, you can't. So she, when we were recording this song, she pulled this line out and it wasn't even in the song. She just started singing it right away.
Well, I think I said, walking through the doorway. And
yeah, you did.
You just looked at me and I'm like,
what?
Why did I even say that?
You might have even said talking through the doorway. Talking through the doorway.
Don't know why I'm saying that. You see, those are the parts. You know, unfortunately, I don't have a lot of the original files, which I don't know what's happening with my computer. Things are not... saving properly for me. I gotta fix that, and so I'm losing some of my original files,
yeah,
which are the best ones to listen to because there's bloopers in there
and we're not high.
Speaking of being not high,
Karen,
you are the queen of segues.
I mean, I do try. I have a lot of experience here.
You ready for this?
Yeah, go. We're not high. To everybody out there, we are not high.
I'm high right now.
Yeah,
actually,
I'm not high even in the least. Honestly, though, today we are not high.
No, we're not high.
No, we did have Kelsey's, so we're a little burpy. We're a little gassy.
We're a little burpy. We're going to try to keep that to ourselves.
Yeah, but we are not high.
The funny one that's where you just go, I'm high. It's when you were at my place in the hallways. All you could was like a...
Smell the weed?
Yeah.
I'm high.
And you go, well, I'm high. So I had to throw that one in the middle
of
it.
You had to, of course.
Oh, my God. So every once in a while, I have a rant.
Uh-oh, I can feel it coming, Karen.
So why don't I play a couple clips of my rants? Are you okay with
that? I'd love that.
Usually, well, sometimes you instigate the rants.
Oops, sure.
Here we go.
Your mother. I'm your mama. Honestly, you don't want to come out because this is a big cult dirty word and you're going to have to learn, so I might as well start teaching you now. Hannah can't eat now. Hannah needs a drink.
Hannah was hungry.
Hold my feeding tube. For God's sakes, for the love of God, you zitty little pizza face man, cut it out. Don't you get it?
I want to see taints. I want to see everything.
Fuck you and your taints.
No, you know what? Karen, taints are real.
Oh, I had a question asked to me today.
Is it?
Do cats have taints?
Yes.
No.
What?
I don't know.
Of course they do.
I can't see under all that fur, and I ain't looking.
Well, you know what? Cats have taints.
Oh. So yeah, as you can hear by the last one, you really get me going sometimes.
I do have to say, though, I think that cats have taints.
Okay, we're not going to carry on. But you know what? The one thing that you do do.
What do I do do?
What you do do is this.
Okay, so Karen's most... she gets so annoyed when I do this. Ready?
I have my headphones off right now.
Yeah, she takes her headphones off. She cannot... Or this.
Okay. You bastard, stop! And Erica just laughs. She just has this dumb look on her face, this dumb grin.
It's because I know how much she enjoys it.
Yeah, well, how many about you? I'd like to know. How many of you? See? There's
how
a clip.
Many of
how
you?
How many of you? Don't like those sounds, you know? Just let me know, because it's highly annoying. I can't talk. Okay, so, you know...
Can I just tell you one sound that I do like, and it's going to sound weird?
What?
I like the sound of a car, like a blinker, like when you make a left or a right, but it has to be a certain car.
Click, click, click.
Yeah. Like, it's just...
Have you ever listened to the, like, ASMR sounds? It's like crinkling sounds.
Oh, yeah,
and,
yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
Combing of hair, yep. Kind of thing. So at night, I listen to this one. It's, really chill music, and it's got like a very faint heartbeat in the back,
right?
And it's got these like ASMR sounds, and it's like I just go away. I'm like, and I'm a difficult sleeper, but when I put it on, it usually takes me about 4 to 6 hours to fall asleep.
But when she falls asleep,
I'm attributing to the 4 to 6 hours of the ASMR.
She is asleep for a good solid 10 minutes.
Could you imagine if I wrote that as a review? It works in 4 to 6 hours.
4 to 6 hours, you will be sleeping like a baby.
Oh, my God. Okay, well, you know what? I think we need talking about relaxing things.
Yeah.
I really think that we've talked about Anne Murray, and she's almost like a...
she's a Canadian staple is what she is.
She's
like Rita McNeil.
One of the things about Anne Murray is that she's almost become like a mascot for our show. We bring her up a lot.
Yeah, we do.
So I'm just going to play a little something, you know, about how we talk about Anne Murray.
Okay.
You ready?
Yeah.
Didn't Anne Murray come up with a song?
Yeah. I have my wings and fly away. Da, 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 I'm Anne Murray, for anybody who's American or from another country, she is a Canadian icon.
Yeah. Listen to this part. Listen to this. Okay, so what is going on with Anne Murray? She said whatever the snowbird told her is the thing that she would do.
Okay, I'm going to tell you a story about Anne Murray.
What if I told her to kill the old lady across the street?
Well, I'm going to tell you what this means.
All right.
Okay.
So you can answer this.
All right. So I'm originally from Thornhill, like born and raised, grew up.
No, Gracie.
No, Gracie is not from Thornhill. Shut your mouth, Gracie. Anne Murray as well lived in Thornhill. She had a house in Thornhill. So she lived there. And the big story was she was this raging lesbian. And she ended up falling. So she was married with 2 kids to a man. And she ended up falling in love with her security guard, who was a woman.
Was that her snowbird?
And I think that was her snowbird. I'm winking wink. Right now.
Yeah.
Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
Anything that my snowbird... Hey, get over here, baby.
Come here, my little snowbird.
And I would do that.
Yeah, I mean...
Oh, now I'm going to have to go through her whole anthology of music.
You have to. She's got some Hippo in the Bathtub.
I listened to that one of those songs.
Did you like it by chance? Or...
No, it was very country.
It's not a country song.
No, it's very twangy.
Well, we beg to differ.
Okay. Well.
Come on. Just let me play like a tiny little clip here. Just a touch.
That sounds very country.
No, I don't think this
Did
is
you
country.
Hear the, that is a slide guitar. That's country.
Close your eyes. It's time to dream of all the places that you've never seen.
Okay, can you turn this off, please?
I wanted to get to the hippo in the bathtub part.
It doesn't talk about a hippo in a bathtub.
Well, there is a hippo in a bathtub, so hang on.
I listened to the whole damn song. That's why I can't tolerate it again. And she does not want to talk about...
In my soup, monkeys and rabbits.
Look at them poop.
Gosh, oh gee, but
I'm going to smash my head with a hammer if you keep playing this.
So I listened to my parents, Doug and Marie. They used to take us to her house on Halloween, and she used to give out full bags of Lay's chips. Just throwing that out there.
So that makes you an icon, like a hero on the street when you're doing stuff like that.
She was not just a hero in the streets. She was a hero in the sheets.
Just ask her snowbird.
Is that bird feeding the bed or
are you happy to see me?
It's like, you know, the saying, I wouldn't kick her out of bed for eating crackers.
Yeah.
How hot is she? Because crackers, crumbs.
I'm going to put her at a mid 80s tennis player. Hot.
I'd kick her out of bed.
You would?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm not saying I'd want to be with her.
But, like, crackers in bed.
Oh, I didn't quite get it. She had crackers in bed? Oh, screw that. No, no, no.
No, no, I can't.
No, I'm not eating crackers.
I'm not eating crackers. Okay.
And
we're moving on.
That's moving on. Well, since we're on the subject of music, why don't I play something here about some silly songs you and I have made up?
I think that would be great. I'd like to hear them.
Or, yes. I think one of my favorites is in here.
Okay. So, it's kind of self-explanatory, I guess.
Okay, here we go.
I've just been feeling so down lately. Look,
my absolute favorite.
I know a place where you can feel all right.
Tell me, mama.
Go ask Alice when she's 10 feet tall.
I wish I knew this song so I could sing along. Lollipop, lollipop, oh lolly, 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 lollipop.
Boom, boom, boom.
Come on.
What is wrong with us?
I like it when we go into the chaka. Or some of my favorites is when you go like, oh yeah.
Okay, wait.
Oh yeah.
My favorite is that one.
I don't know how we can even get that deep.
Well, you're in luck.
Well, you're in luck.
I know a place where you can feel all right.
I know a place where you can feel all right.
And honestly, guys, most of the time, it's just made up.
Tell me, mama.
Thank you, daddy.
Oh, okay, that was a little creepy.
There was a line, and Karen stepped over it. Yes. That's what happened.
That often happens.
Yeah, that's okay.
You know all about that because you do it yourself.
I do it a lot.
Okay.
Myself.
Well, so I asked some questions. Put it out there. Anybody, you have any questions, comments, anything about the show?
Ask away.
Ask away. So actually, before I do that, I also asked people to send in some voice recordings of themselves with something to say about Stat. So I'm going to put one in right now.
Okay, great.
And this is from Taryn Hanan. Yeah.
Okay, Taryn. All right, we're going to call you Taryn.
Okay, here we go.
Hey, this is Taryn, not Jody Knight out in Alberta, Canada. I started listening to Stat last year when I was out on a quest looking for medical podcasts. And aside from a few other podcasts I do listen to, I found that any other podcast I found that was related to medicine either dumbed down the information way too much, the episodes were way too short, or some of the information presented was so outside and above my interests and scope of knowledge that I was actually zoning out and not taking in any of the information. With Karen's background in emergency medicine and having Erica give her input as a medic, I found that Stat was actually the perfect combination of everything that I find interesting with medicine and medical issues. And the fact that Karen will take feedback and constructive criticism from the listeners to improve future episodes, that shows that she actually really does care what we think and helps her just create the best content for the podcast. So, thanks again, Kren and Erka, and catch you on the next episode.
Isn't that the best?
Oh, Taryn, thank you so much.
That means so much to me. Thank you. And, you know, I do put a lot into it. Erica and I both put a lot into it.
Karen puts more.
Well, as Erica said, I didn't find her until 75 episodes in.
Yeah,
so. You know, so it would have. But when Erica's involved, she puts just as much into it as well. But
it's like an eagle lost its egg, and then 75 eggs later, it found its egg.
Yeah, it's exactly like that. Thanks, Taryn. And thank you for our little medicine men.
Oh my God, I can't wait till I get
plague
mine.
Doctor.
Mine's in the mail.
You know where mine is? It's at my bedside table. That's how much I love it.
I love it so much.
I like touch its beak every day.
Okay. And again, there was a line and Karen crossed it.
The episodes are every day. I mean, what?
Why did I say that? Again, see? Things just came out of Karen's mouth.
I don't know why I said that.
I think
that.
We're overtired. I'm sleeping right now.
Okay. And I'm kind of sleeping. All right. So first comment question from Anne Clothier. God, I'm terrible with last names.
It's fine. I'm sure she's not going to be offended.
Okay, so apologies if you've already done this and I just haven't found the episodes yet, but I'd love to hear an origin stories episode from you and some of the others who are regularly on the show. How and why did you choose careers in nursing and EMS or other caring professions? Do you have any advice for someone who is considering entering the field? Anything you would do differently now and that you have extensive experience? Shoot.
Okay.
It's always bouncing her melon off.
Yeah,
the...
sorry. I chose to be a paramedic in my early 20s. So I love healthcare. I love every aspect of, I'm like a natural born caregiver. So it wasn't hard for me to choose that profession. And getting to drive a big fast box down a road with lights and loud noise, I mean, come on.
Yeah, seriously.
If you know, nowadays it's a lot easier. Stretchers lift themselves. Everything's a power cot.
Yeah.
Stair chairs have like a track. You know, they go up and down kind of with very little assistance from you. So if you're thinking of getting into it, get into it now. Back in the day, everything was manual. You had to, you know, there was a trigger. You lifted up a stretcher with your partner and that, you know, it's backbreaking. So, yeah, I mean, I loved healthcare. So I that's why I chose it. Karen?
I think your personality lends itself to being a paramedic too, like just being out and flying around and, you know, not being tied down to one spot. Because I know you're like a social butterfly and love going out and doing things. So, I always wanted to be a paramedic. Once I started nursing and got into it, and I was just like, oh, I wish I'd have chose to be a paramedic. And then I'm like, oh, what if I wanted to be a flight nurse?
Oh, fuck. I have a buddy who's a flight medic.
Yeah. And yeah. I wasn't able to do it. But anyway, I love the thought too.
She
of
just stuck
being
to the
out,
ER.
Yeah. Just only there.
Just only there. Who cares? Emergencies? Psh, what's that?
So why did I get into nursing? Well, I come from there's a lot of medical people in my family and law people. So you know, that was definitely a factor.
She was too short to become a police officer. Yeah. So she, yeah.
Believe it or not, I started reading medical journals and medical books when I was like 10 or 11. I'd go into the library and everybody was pulling out, like, you know, Dr. Underpants or Mr. Underpants or whatever, Captain Underpants and stuff. And I was like, oh, look at this. And then I'd draw pictures of organs and stuff. Yeah, I was either going to be...
hair growing out of your gums?
Yeah. So I was either going to be a serial killer or a damn good nurse. The thing is, doctors and nurses make great serial killers.
So, Karen, what you're trying to tell us is...
What am I trying to tell you?
I don't know. I'm just kind of scared now.
If I were to be a serial killer, I'd be like Dexter.
Oh, yeah, I'd be like Dexter, too.
I'd go after all of the bad guys.
I would go after bad guys, too.
Yeah, so, I mean, I wouldn't go after good peoples. Okay, do we have any advice about for someone considering entering the medical field? I do. If you want to get into nursing. I think it's important that you really do some research into maybe the kind of nursing that you want to do, because there's so many different types of jobs that you can do as a nurse. If you're already, you know, want to help people and care for people, that's fantastic. But look into that, look into the, like maybe do some volunteering at a hospital,
yeah. Yeah.
Nursing home, like paramedic, you know, the yeah. stations, like just do some volunteering, find out that way, because then you really get the insight as to what stuff that goes on in there. If you know, I find that sometimes nurses can say, don't get in the profession. It's too much of this and too much of that, and it's, you know, blah, not worth it. Not a lot of nurses say that, but, you know, one nurse did say it to me and it really affected me. It didn't change my mind, but I'm like, oh, what is that all about? So try to, like, not take on any of the negative stuff, because sometimes you talk to somebody who's just had it with it.
Yeah.
So volunteer, research. If you love sciences, if you love medicine, you know, just look into all the avenues. Same with being a paramedic. Like, just, do you like being on the road? Do you like being in one
spot? Do you like working for 16 hours a day?
Yeah, different,
you know,
things like that. So
sleeping for 4 hours and starting it all over again.
So I say, do your research, and if yes. you love it, go for it. That's
I agree.
Both very rewarding. It is tough work. Whatever. You know what? What's that saying? It's not work if you love it. I can't say I loved every minute of it, but if I could go back and do that work again, I absolutely would. Okay, so Lorraine asks, okay, well, so thank you, and Cloutier, Clothier?
And something. Thank you something, man.
Okay, so now we have Lorraine Ledwell.
Lorraine.
So one of the things she asks is, we would cover Cotard syndrome. Now, I did touch on it briefly in, I think I was talking about all these different types of strange medical conditions, but Cotard syndrome is when you think you're dead or a body part is dead.
Yes.
So I think that's a really cool thing to cover, so maybe you and I can cover that together.
I am absolutely down with that.
So that is on the list. Now we have Carly Gunther. She said, my favorite series were the Howard Dully lobotomy series. It was terrifying and awful, but this story was so powerful and encouraging. As always, you handled the subject with great care, empathy, and attention to detail. It was my first introduction to this wonderful show, and the entire story still sticks with me. Thank you, Carly. It is my pet project.
Yeah.
If I had just done the lobotomy series and Howard Dully and nothing more, I would have been very happy with that. And the thing is that I go back and I listen to those episodes. I've only done it once before recently, and I just cringe all the way through it because my editing was terrible. My sound was awful. I was so nervous doing it. But I don't think I would ever redo it, just because I think it was just where I was at the time. And I spent probably 6 months researching all of it.
Yeah. You learn with experience, right? Like, it's not just something that, you know, comes and you're going to, you know, mm-hmm.
And so. I got to, you know, meet Howard. We met over Skype and stuff, but I made a friend with Howard as well. So it was just amazing. Also, too, she said, I have so many other things I would love to hear from y'all. I love it. I'm too easy to retype them. Yeah, so she said she did send me some other things. And in regards to postpartum mood disorders and birth trauma. And so I think we'll definitely touch on some of those subjects
okay.
for sure.
Yeah.
Okay, so now Sonia McDonald.
Sonia.
Yeah, cheeky bugger. That was my Scottish accent.
That was really good. That was really good.
It's the only one I can do. She threw it right back at us. What are your favorite topics episodes? Oh, I just said Howard Dully was my favorite. Dr. Lobotomy series were my two favorite ones to cover, just because they were my first and I just invested so much of myself into it and got to meet Howard. But I really do love the psychiatric based episodes the most. I love digging deep into medical history and the psychiatric medical history.
Yeah, I have to agree. I think the experiments and stuff like that is kind of my...
Because they're really kind of grody and awful, but they're also like revolutionary in some sense.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
So sometimes what good comes out of horror. So statistically, which episodes were the most popular? So the most popular out of all of them was the history of medical experiments.
Yeah.
See? I had a shit ton of downloads for that one. And also the strange psychiatric disorders. And those even though those were older ones that I did, like the history of medical experiments, I redid that one.
Okay.
So I lost my downloads from that, so I didn't really know. I forgot how much those were, but it's like three times as higher as any other episode that I've done.
That's amazing.
But in the she also wrote which episodes get the most feedback and comments, and it would be the Dr. Lobotomy and the Howard Dully one. So that means so much to me, because the reason why I started the podcast really was to cover that.
Yeah.
And so it was pretty cool that it was so well received.
Absolutely.
So.
Yeah.
Okay. So that was Sonia. Now, we're going to do one more question and we're going to do some more of our silliness.
Silliness.
Abby Stevens, do you have any advice for first-time podcasters? What platform do you use? Okay. I think we can do a totally separate... one of our episodes, we can talk more about starting a podcast.
I'm going to give it from my point of view, because I, again, joined Karen 25 episodes ago. Maybe 25. I don't know what the number is, but... Karen sets all this shit up. Okay, so I've learned how to set this stuff up, but if it has to do with any editing or anything on the computer, Karen does it all. I do not even touch it. Karen's clearly way better at that. I don't know. Do you want to tell them like the platform you use? And
okay, so basically when I first started doing this,
we used two cans and a string.
Exactly. To a cell phone. I was really wanting to tell these stories and I had no idea where to start. And I was really enjoying a show called Hillbilly Horror Stories. And Jerry, he's great. I was listening to a show and I sent him a message about how much I like his show. And he got back to me like he does with everybody. He's fantastic that way. And I just said, you know, one day I'd like to do a podcast like this. And before you knew it, he was giving me all this advice on how to get started. So a big part of how I even got started and got going is because of Jerry. So he's amazing. But really do a lot of research in regards to what you need to do with to set up a podcast. It some people make it sound like it's a super easy thing to do, and it's not necessarily a difficult thing to do, but there are a lot of steps.
Yeah.
It's not just a computer and a microphone. There's so much more to it, and you can start off really simple. I would not put a ton of money into it. Just there's mics out there that can sound really great. You can even do this off a tablet if you wanted to. There's platforms that start off as free that you don't even like. You don't have to put a penny into it. What I might do if there is a more interest in this, as we can do an episode, or I can put some stuff up in terms of guide you guys in directions of inexpensive but good mics, whether you want to do USB or XLR, easy editing programs to use, that kind of stuff. But really it starts with an idea, and if you want to share your idea, then you know what, fuck it, go for it. And yeah. If I can be of any help, PM me and I will do my best to help you get started.
That means private message.
Yeah. Private, not premenstrual.
Sliding into my DMs. What's a DM?
Direct message, I think.
Oh, just joking.
Okay, so now let's move on to... Eric and I often do things that just blow our mind. Things that just blow our mind.
Yeah.
And a lot of it has come from posts that you guys did on Facebook.
Yeah.
So here's a little clip of Erica... having a problem understanding things.
Okay. I don't understand it.
I don't understand. With, like, her nose?
I don't even understand. I just, I don't understand. I don't understand. You know what, Karen?
Do you know any of those I could have done?
I don't understand.
Another one you do a lot of is give it to me.
Give it to me. Give it to me.
So that was a...
Give it to me. And the give other it to me.
Another one is you and I often come up with some very strange voices.
We do. You, yeah.
And you were going to say you, weren't you?
I was going to say you mostly.
Oh, I don't know. Well, here, let's play this and they can be the judge, okay?
Okay.
Hi, America.
Oh, I don't think I sound like that.
Yeah, you do. Oh, do I? Because you sound like this. I love you, Daddy.
Pair of panties.
A spare pair of panties.
What's that smell?
What is that smell? Help me. Help me, please. Please, sir, help me.
Is that a bag of apples, or are you happy to see me?
I'm happy to see you. What is wrong with us?
I don't know, but it's awesome.
There's something wrong with us.
Those are just some of the craziest voices that we do, but we do them all the time. And like, it's not like we...
Like even sitting at a restaurant.
Oh my, yes.
We made friends with a waitress today. We went, Karen took me for lunch, a birthday lunch. So our waitress was very... she liked us, I think. She probably thought we were odd or something, or we were on a day pass, but that's fine.
She brought over, we were like half done our drinks, and she brought over, like we had these big Diet Cokes or Diet Pepsis, whatever. She brought over another one, and I'm like, I don't think I can finish it. She goes, well, I just brought them over so you wouldn't yell at us. And yell at me. I'm like, we would never yell at you, though.
Never. We look like we would.
Yeah, but we're not, like, there was these gross guys behind us that were like, our beers are too warm.
You know what? Speaking of gross guys.
Uh-oh. What do you got?
Well, okay. So it's kind of funny. I don't want to offend anyone because that's not what I'm about. But I did post this on my Facebook page, and it's this girl, and she asks, what is it like to sleep with a guy? And the thread of all of the comments are hilarious. I'll read some of them.
And I know that you could just as easily apply it to
women,
whatever gender that you're,
yeah,
like,
oh yeah, absolutely
opposite to. So, but I mean, they're funny.
So what is it like to sleep with a guy? Okay. It's like going to a really expensive restaurant and leaving hungry. Ever been disappointed? It's like that. You know, when you have to sneeze and you're building up to it and then it just goes away. Yeah. It's like that. This one's very true. Ready? It's like asking a toddler to clean something up and you're like, oh, good job. Thank you for helping. And once they walk away, you finish the job yourself. Ever had a cat bring you a dead bird and like they did something for you and you're supposed to like it even though it's vile? Yeah, it's like that. This is my favorite one. My last one I'll read. It's like ordering something from Wish. If anybody's ever ordered from Wish, it is, I work for the post office and, we get these big containers of, you know, packets and stuff. And it's insane. It takes, I'm going to say if you order something from there, it takes about 2 months to get there. So it's kind of self-explanatory, I guess.
I ordered something from Wish, expecting never to get it. Like, I honestly was like, oh, I'm going to order it. And if I don't.
If I get it, I get it. If I don't, I don't.
And there were socks that say fuck you on the bottom.
Yeah.
And I just thought they were the funniest things. I think I paid like $2.50 for them.
Yep.
And I got them like a month later and I'm like, oh, so you actually do get something that you order from there?
You do. I've gotten a bunch of from Wish, and if I don't get it, you get your money back.
Well, it surprised me, and a happy surprise. Now I've got these fuck you socks, and I don't even know where they were. I was just happy to get them.
And they're gone now, so Karen had them for about a day and a half.
Fuck you. Okay, so you know what? Why don't we play another message from one of our listeners? Are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
Hello, hello, hello. I'm transmitting back from podcast land. Actually, I'm just from Puerto Rico, or Puerto Rico. Así que, yes. Hola. Anyway, I'm right now living in Virginia. So I actually came across your show when I was looking for medical podcasts. And lo and behold, yours was one of the first ones I stumbled upon. And from the start, I loved it. Because when I saw that you were doing a series on Dr. Lobotomy, I was already hooked. I just graduated from med school, so right now I'm in the process of taking my last board and applying towards a psychiatry residency, so it goes hand in hand. Anyway, I also loved the Lacey Spears episodes. So actually, I use your show as an excuse to work out, so thank you for keeping me healthy. I will schedule my hiking around your show's length, and that way it's just me and your show, and I'm one with nature and one with your show, so I love it. It keeps me going every day. So I want to thank you guys for giving us a great show. I want to thank Karen, because, I mean, you've got such a great personality, and it comes across in your podcast. So anyway, I wish you the best of luck, and have a great day.
That, I, can you believe it?
Are you single? Just
honest to God, I hear these messages, and I'm like, are they talking about stats?
I just want her to say Puerto Rico again.
Yeah, Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico.
That's not me making fun of your accent.
No,
you have
it's
a beautiful
fucking amazing.
Accent.
I know.
And I'm just like, ha, I ruin it. But thank you. That is amazing.
That's awesome.
I never thought I'd heard someone say, listen to my podcast and working out. But maybe is it because you're saying because you get so riled up because
yeah.
the cases are so like, it gets you out there and you can get all your energy out. Cause,
yeah.
Yeah. Either way, thank you for the message. That was friggin' amazing. And speaking of amazing,
uh-oh.
I have the top list of the shit, some of the shit that I think is the funniest stuff Eric has ever said.
Oh, no.
And now, like, there were so many, but I think these are the ones that I just died. And part of the reason why they're funny is because when I'm editing, I don't always catch the stuff because you and I just go back and forth so much.
Yeah, we go so quick.
And I don't always catch the stuff you say. So here we go.
My wife just opened her mouth and all I can see is hair.
Are you sure you're looking at the right mouth, ma'am? Grabbed an object and maybe was like, oh, that's a real inside itch. Now, I'm going to say I could 94 years old. You know, I'm sure it was an accident. I don't think
yeah.
they were like, let's tip this bitch.
Jesus,
I know that sounds horrible. Found you. You're under arrest. Stinky the loner dolphin.
I still can't handle it.
Wait, you can't handle Stinky the loner dolphin or?
Everything you say, it just kills me. So the first one was when we covered the one about people had teeth growing out of their gums. And then you said, you were talking to, and you just said, are you sure you're looking in the right mouth? I died. And I don't know, just, I didn't expect to hear Stinky the loner dolphin. That just had the way it came out of your mouth. And, I don't know, that just, you kill me every episode, but there's just some things that maybe I didn't catch the first time.
I don't even know how the shit comes out of my mouth, to be honest. I really have no idea. So,
well, that's why it's so good.
Yeah.
I mean, okay, here's one where it's the both of us.
Okay.
Going back and forth. And I have to admit, I thought I was incredibly hilarious. And I didn't, it wasn't until afterwards that I listened to it and I was like, this is some of the best you and me that I've ever heard. So
okay.
I don't know if you guys will agree, but I got to play it.
Okay, done.
And the mother was like, I need some gravel. Somebody give me a shot of the gravel. Oh, wait a minute. Would her milk be like butter? Because she was whipped around.
She was churned.
I churned up that damn milk.
I promise you guys, we are not high right now.
Honest to God.
Why we always sound like we're fucked up?
But the way you said it, she was churned.
She was churned.
Oh, man. I've listened to that so many times. Again, with
it's Karen's ringtone now.
Oh, God. Just the way you said it. She was churned. I'm all spit out right now.
Karen's a little churned right now.
Oh my God. Okay. You know, we're on a roll with these. Let's just, maybe we can finish them up and do a couple more things and then the show. Isn't that what we were supposed to do?
Time's a ticking, Karen.
You
keep on licking.
Okay. So here we go. Here's another one. Sometimes we don't even know why we're saying what we're saying.
No.
It just comes out and we're like,
oh well.
And we just flow with it.
Yeah.
And here we go. Is it Schmiggle Schmoggle or Dingly Dongle?
And I'm like, Schmiggle Schmoggle.
It was Schmiggle Schmoggle.
That fucking Schmiggle Schmoggle.
You don't want sweaty chappies.
You don't want sweaty chaps.
No sweaty flappy chaps.
No. He is using that dorsal fin for...
It's not chopping cheese.
He is not chopping cheese.
Get out the salad spinner.
Let's go. Spin that bitch.
Oh my God. I just,
Something's wrong with us.
I think we somehow know, but don't know. Because, I mean, I don't know where I came up. She's not chopping cheese. He's not chopping cheese.
He's not. Well, his dorsal fin, you thought sharp knife. I think that's what was going through your head.
But who chops cheese? Like,
with their dorsal fin.
Schmingle, schmingle.
Oh, my God. How do you...
I don't know the name of something, I come up with weird things like that. Like, I call... Mary, like, is always laughing at me because I don't know the name of something, so I just say the first thing that comes out of my mouth, like, that Musk guy, I call him Evil Knievel.
You do that a lot, actually, with people's names.
I just, whatever comes, Mary's favorite bird is this, like, one-eyed crack hatch blue wing, and I think it's a cedar waxwing. Yeah, but, so I was lucky to think of it this time, but I come up with these things, but... Now that we've been together for so long, she knows what I mean now when I say half the stuff. So,
which is amazing. That is
so. That's why you hear it on the show, because it's just us being us. That's the best part of it. Is I think we don't have to put anything on. We're just who we are.
Yeah. Which is. I want to hear another message.
Okay. Here we go.
Happy 100th episode! I'm so glad that you guys are still going strong, and we get to listen to you and be a part of your lives. Now, here is my super important. Urgent question. Which way is the right way to hang the toilet paper?
Oh, I'm going to answer this.
Okay.
Over. You never hang it under.
I don't care.
That's savage.
You say that's savage?
Yes.
I honestly don't care.
Oh, I care.
You know how I hang it?
How?
I put the roll on top of the empty roll.
You're a jerk. You're an absolute jerk. Okay, so...
I'm not leaving you without toilet paper. I'm putting it... on top where you could access it. And if you choose to hang the toilet paper afterwards, that's your prerogative.
I'm calling Mary.
Mary has come to terms with it.
No, I've had enough of your...
Oh, are you going to go on a rant now, Erica?
I mean, it's the wrong way to... You have to put the toilet paper. My parents would have killed me if I didn't hang toilet paper.
Well, no wonder you're messed up.
Right?
Maybe it explains everything about you. Erica's rocking back. Erica does get mad at me every once in a while, and this is the perfect example of it. But honestly, I am just so relaxed about it. I came up with an invention. It's called the toilet paper shelf.
And it's just a shelf that goes above your toilet paper roll.
It's just a little shelf, and you place your toilet paper on there.
No.
Why?
Because no.
Well,
it's just wrong.
I'm not all tight-assed about it. As long as... I can get to the heart of the matter, no problem.
Wipe till it's white. Okay, so let's hear another one, Karen, shall we?
Thank you for that message. It's absolutely amazing. Excellent question. Thank you so much. You know what? Let's not forget, we've got one more. And this is from our Lorraine.
Lorraine, sweet Lorraine.
Okay, here we go. Now, here's the thing. It was sent to me PM or private message on Facebook, and I couldn't figure out how to make it into MP3 file. So if it doesn't sound as good as it could, it's because I'm playing it off the Facebook page. Blah, 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 blah.
Hello, only me. Just want to say thank you. I haven't really got a favorite episode. I like each and every one of them. Some of them that shock and upset me. It chill me to my core and bring me to tears. Yet I return because the research is done so well. It's thoughtful, even though it's incredibly hard to do. And I know sometimes it's brought you to tears too. I return for the informative content, for the creativity, for the discussion. You aren't afraid to say what you really mean, and you aren't afraid to let others have their say too, especially on the group. And you also aren't afraid to be wrong. I love the fact that you care about your podcast so much. It shows in each and every word. So thank you. Thank you for that. And long may stat rain.
Oh, Lorraine.
Oh, Lorraine. Honestly, when I listened to that yesterday, I got all choked up. I got all choked up listening to all of them, or actually the toilet paper one gave me a good giggle. But, you know, You guys know how we feel about Lorraine. She's amazing.
Oh, Lorraine.
Oh, gosh, Lorraine.
Let's, what do you got? Do you
okay, a couple more questions, and we're getting to near the end here, believe it or not. One of the suggestions was from Sarah Butler, and she said her favorite was the Nellie Bly episode. Absolutely my fave, although old school psych treatments really fascinate me. It's weird to see where they came from to where they are in treatment of mental health. What would you consider? Oh, sorry. Would you consider reviewing Candace Newmaker? Interested in hearing your thoughts about the practices of rebirthing. First of all, you and I are on the same board in terms of studying psychiatric medicine and stuff like that. I love it. And in terms of rebirthing, I am 100% going to cover that. Just quick and dirty. Rebirthing is this really quack. It's quackery. Where it's not, I don't believe any psychiatrists have do this treatment. It's mostly like, you know, untrained people or therapists or whatever, untrained therapists. It's when they take a person, they wrap them up in blankets and they lean on them and they're supposed to be rebirthed back into the world. So they take them down where they have to fight their way out of this quote unquote birth canal.
No, thank you.
And then, you know, they're reborn kicking and screaming. And then they can, like, it's for people that, for kids or humans that have attachment disorder where they're not attached.
So it just brings on PTSD is basically what it does.
Basically. And this one famous case was with a child named Candace Newmaker, who was actually killed while one of these rebirthing things happened, one of these treatments. It's a horrific story, and it's one of the scariest chapters in terms of therapy, so I'm 100% going to cover that case. I think I'll have it out sometime this year, and thank you so much, Sarah, for bringing that forth. Another question from Lorraine. She has a quick question. Bit of a silly one. If KK and Erica had an alter ego, who and what would you be?
Oh, God. If I had an alter... I don't know. You go, and I'm going to...
I'd be a vigilante, man.
Oh, okay.
I would, like, totally, at night... Like, I'd be Dexter, probably. At night, I'd get dressed in, like, you know, inconspicuous clothing. Like, I'd be, like, a ninja. And I would go find the bad people and take care of business.
Yeah. Again, Karen, you're bringing up... that you want to kill people. I'm a little creeped out, guys.
Didn't say kill them. I just said take care of business.
Well, I'm sorry. I think I know what take care of business is.
Well, you never know because you're not going to be there. But this is my alter ego. I guess I did say I'd be like Dexter a little bit.
Yeah.
But you know the kind of people I would deal with.
Karen's a little murdery right now.
I'm not murdery. Well, that's if I had an alter ego.
If I had
But come on, tell me the truth. Let's get down to this for a second.
Okay.
If a... sick and twisted pedophile rapist murderer was in front of you right now,
I'd kill him.
You'd go, no.
No,
you would probably get to them before me.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'd draw it out a bit. I might.
I think my alter ego would be like a forest animal, some sort of.
Yes.
Maybe would like a crow.
Would you be like a furry? Like one of those people that dress up?
Hey, let's do an episode on furries.
Oh my God, we absolutely have to.
Do we dress up when we do the episode? I'm just joking. We're not dressing up.
No, you got that hat, that cat helmet, that cat
hood. You don't have to tell people.
Yeah, that's right. No, she doesn't.
We'll post it on.
She doesn't.
I don't even know where it is. Probably, I lost it somewhere.
I drove home with it on one day.
We, I went into this stupid store and it was around Halloween and it's a cat head and you can see through its eyes and but it's a massive furry cat head. We'll post it on.
It's so funny.
Yeah. You need a tail and you're a furry, basically.
I brought it home. I did drive a little bit in the car, not a long time, but just like up to an intersection.
You have to,
and there's like people were like, I thought I was going to cause an accident, but then I wore it at home. And when Mary came home, I was standing in the hallway just with that helmet on my head with the big, huge thing on my head. And she just like probably jumped about three steps back. I don't know why she's still with me. Oh, Mary. I have to get my shit together. Not you.
Yeah.
Okay. So last comment is from Emma Clayton. Buttwell, and I'm sorry. I get to the Buttwell, and I'm. I love you, Emma. My favorite podcast by far. far is Dr. Lobotomy. It got me hooked. I do miss the suture room, but know it's hard to revisit some of those memories. I really love the Kren and Urca banter. I would like to hear more about how fish eggs are digested in the human body, and I don't want to grow any fish in my belly either, Erica.
Emma, it's going to happen. I'm going to, you know what, let me do some research on the fish digestion.
That's going to require you to eat them. Egg.
I'm not eating any.
Okay, I will.
Okay, Karen will eat them. I'll do the research and we'll find out what happens.
Okay, and I'll be the person that does, okay, I'll be the clinical trial
when
person.
You have fish egg babies, that's fine.
Alrighty then. I'll
you don't know what
them.
You're going to have.
They'll be like half human, half fish.
Mm-hmm. Oh. See, she says she doesn't like that sound, but really.
No, that was my fish sound. Okay, well, Erica. Okay, so you know what? I think we have covered everything here. And I don't know. I had a lot of fun with today's episode.
I had a really good time.
Reminiscing on some of our crazier moments together. And there's going to be a lot more to come because we just like doing this.
Can't wait.
And so more episodes coming up in the future. More Kren and Urca show, putting everything together. Next Henry Cotton episode will come out. Now, I wanted to say quickly that there was some technical issues in the last episode. I have had some difficulties fixing them, but moving forward, that will no longer be a problem. Please hang in there with me. And thank you all.
Thank you, guys.
Hanging in. We love you.
We love you.
Happy 100th episode. There wouldn't be a 100th episode if you guys didn't listen.
And be kind and rewind, I think.
Spay
and neuter your pets.
Yes. And take care of each other.
And no glove, no love.
Erica just doesn't want to ever be serious. But she can be.
When?
She's challenging me. Listen, guys, take care of yourself. Mask, gloves, all that. No, not gloves. Wash your hands. All that kind of shit.
Hand sanny.
You know what? People that listen to this know what to do. Love you guys.
You touch your genitals, you use hand sanitizer.
Okay.
Okay.
Peace.
Peace.
One love.